And choral evensong today comes from St. Anne's Cathedral, Belfast. The service is Stanford in G, the anthem Greater Love Hath No Man by John Ireland, and the closing voluntary is the Sonata No. 3 in A by Mendelssohn.
O Lord, open thou our lips,
and our mouth shall show forth thy praise.
O God, make speed to save us. To the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Psalm 119, verses 145 to 176.
Thank you.
The first lesson is written in the book of Zephaniah, chapter 3, beginning at verse 14. Sing aloud, O daughter of Zion, shout, O Israel. Rejoice and exult with all your heart, O daughter of Jerusalem. The Lord has taken away the judgments against you. He has cast out your enemies. The King of Israel, the Lord, is in your midst. You shall fear evil no more. On that day it shall be said to Jerusalem, Do not fear, O Zion. Let not your hands grow weak. The Lord your God is in your midst, a warrior who gives victory. He will rejoice over you with gladness. He will renew you in his love. He will exult over you with loud singing as on a day of festival. I will remove disaster from you so that you will not bear reproach for it. Behold, at that time I will deal with all your oppressors, and I will save the lame and gather the outcast, and I will change their shame into praise and renown in all the earth. At that time I will bring you home at the time when I gather you together. Yea, I will make you renowned and praised among all the peoples of the earth. When I restore your fortunes before your eyes, says the Lord. Here ends the first lesson.
Yeah.
The second lesson is written in St. Matthew's Gospel, chapter 11, beginning at verse 20. Then Jesus began to upbraid the cities where most of his mighty works had been done, because they did not repent. Woe to you, Chorazin! Woe to you, Bethsaida! For if the mighty works done in you had been done in Tyre and Sidon, they would have repented long ago in sackcloth and ashes. But I tell you, it shall be more tolerable on the day of judgment for Tyre and Sidon than for you. And you, Capernaum, will you be exalted to heaven? You shall be brought down to Hades. For if the mighty works done in you had been done in Sodom, it would have remained until this day. But I tell you that it shall be more tolerable on the day of judgment for the land of Sodom than for you. At that time, Jesus declared, I thank thee, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, that thou hast hidden these things from the wise and understanding, and revealed them to babes. Yea, Father, for such was thy gracious will. All things have been delivered to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. Here ends the second lesson. I believe in God.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life eternal. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray.
Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Almighty and everlasting God, mercifully look upon our infirmities, and in all our dangers and necessities, stretch forth thy right hand to help and defend us, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
O God, from whom all come all holy desires, all good counsels and all just works, give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that we, being defended by thee from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness, through Jesus Christ our Savior. Lighten our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy, defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of thy only Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Anthem by John Allen, Greater Love Hath No Man.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Let us pray for our country and all in authority. Grant, O Lord, to us and to all the people of this land that true patriotism and love of country which are in harmony with the mind of Christ. Take away from us all hatred and prejudice. Give us more charity and forbearance one with another. Grant to our leaders wisdom and singleness of purpose, and to us all the spirit of willing service and cheerful sacrifice, that we may fulfill thy purposes and glorify thy holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray for peace. And let us remember in our prayers all who have suffered through civil strife. O God our Father, we pray for all victims of civil strife, the wounded, the bereaved, the broken in mind and heart, the homeless, the workless, and the despairing. We remember those who live in the shadow of fear and intimidation, and those who witness for thee in situations of difficulty. We pray for all who work for peace, that they may be preserved in danger and sustained in their task. Grant in thy mercy a change of heart to those who practice or support deeds of violence, that they may turn instead to peaceful and constructive ways, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Eternal Father, of whom the whole family in heaven and earth is named, unite us as we worship thee here with all who in every place and in every land are lifting up their hearts to thee, so that thy church throughout the world may, with the church in heaven, offer up one sacrifice of thanksgiving to the praise and honor of thy holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore.
Amen.
Hymn 590.
Thank you.
Choral Evensong came from St. Anne's Cathedral, Belfast. The service was Stanford in G, the anthem was Greater Love Hath No Man by John Ireland, and the closing voluntary, Sonata No. 3 in A by Mendelssohn. The organist and master of the choristers was Jonathan Gregory, and the assistant organist was Edwin Gray.